Good day, fellow investors. Today I'll share my full analysis, sum of parts, value in detailed analysis of the Argentinian conglomerate Cresud. So on one part we have a leading Latin American agricultural company with 800,000 of hectares of land across Argentina, Brazil, something in Uruguay and Paraguay. So they are really focused on agriculture, and that's one part of the company. They have 31 farms across the region. They are developing those farms, they are selling when they are developed and trying to find the best return on investment. However, Cresud is really not just about farming. There is also IRSA. It is a real estate company that owns the Lau Lau Hotel, the most expensive hotel in Argentina, Banco Hipotecario, the Lipstick Building in Manhattan, and a lot of investments in Israel, real estate, the largest supermarket chain in Israel, Cellcom, Telecom, whatever. Then there is IRSA, another subsidiary, office buildings, premium office buildings in Buenos Aires, malls, 16 malls, the best avenues of Buenos Aires. So really, prime real estate properties. But that's not all. It's huge growth story. There are huge growth opportunities to invest some land to build new malls, new offices. So the company has been really growing over the next 20 years and will keep growing even more. This is an example of what they have in plan to build on the 70 hectares land that they have in prime location in Buenos Aires. So let's dig into each part, agriculture, Israel, land, whatever, to see what is the value of this company and where can this lead us. Let's see. So this is the structure of the company. You can see farmland and then IRSA with real estate. So let's first look at another, take another better look at the farmland, the value there, and then at the real estate segment. So a lot of farms, as said, 800,000 acres across Latin America, huge production of corn, wheat, cattle, all the things that feed the world, as they said. Here is their strategy. They buy land, develop that land, create it into highly productive, highly yielding land, and then they sell that land. For now, it has led to an internal rate of return of 16%, but they always sell the most expensive land with the lowest yield. So those are really cherry-picked sales. From a value perspective, I have estimated the value of Brazil Agro, the company that is traded on the New York Stock Exchange that Cresud owns 43.4% of. The market cap is 200 million, so their stake is 84 million. I think that's a fair value. So the value in Argentina is a little bit more valuable, so I would put a value there of 250 million to sum up with the other land. We are at 350 million in the value for the land bank, and I think it's a fair value because nobody is going to buy that in one hand. So catalyst will be slow development, slow sales, and they are making about 50 million of profits. So discount that to 15% returns, and we are then again at 350 million. Just a note here, I'm analyzing Cresud from a perspective, okay, I want 15% returns. If you want lower percent returns, just calculate the difference and you will see how Cresud value grows. It's a great company, but I'm looking for 15% given the current situation in Argentina and current yields and discount rates there. So keep in mind when I'm discussing, if you want 10%, Cresud is definitely a long-term buy. Brasil Agro is one of the largest companies in terms of arable land. So here is the summary, a lot of hectares. And then we go to the book value of the company. According to the company and Deloitte that made an analysis, the book value is 1.4 billion of the land, and that would lead to a net asset value per share of 24, which is double the real book, the current book value, but that is because of currencies, as the Brazilian currencies got devalued lately. However, when we know that those farms are cherry-picked, those farms are sold like that, that it takes a lot of time to sell those farms because sales are not that fast, We are talking 22 Brazilian reals per share or $6 per share. The accounting is lower, 3.4. When you discount that to a 15% return, then you get to the current stock price. So I think it's a fair value for Brasilagro. So the land, let's put 350 million on that and let's see what's next. Now, Cresud owns 63.8% of IRSA, while IRSA owns 86.3% of IRSA commercial properties. That I have analyzed in a video separately here, so I'll put at the end of this video, I'll put that video again. Or just click on the link above in the cards and you can see that video. So this is what we have to analyze, and there is IRSA commercial properties, my fair value for IRSA's stake in the commercial property segment was 700 million, valuing the company at 800 something million for, again, a 15% return, 10%, and that immediately jumps significantly higher. There are some hotels, there is a land bank for use, and there is international Condor, a REIT, there is the lipstick building that they own 49% in New York, and then is there are Israeli operations where they also own the HSBC building in New York and the Banco Hipotecario 40% stake. So a lot of value there. Let's see one by one what there is. Hotels, great free hotels in Buenos Aires, Intercontinental, Sheraton Libertador, Liao Liao, the most expensive hotel is in Argentina. And I have found JLL's research showing recent transactions for similar hotels, more expensive hotels. So Sheraton Hotel Park Tower got $333 per room per key. And as the Intercontinental are prices from what IRSA owns are half the Sheraton and one fifth of the Four Seasons, I would give it a value of around the 50K per room, 309 rooms, I get 15 million or 11 million for IRSA's share. Same calculations for Libertador and Liao Liao make it that IRSA's stake in those hotels is about 25 million because they don't own 100%. Not much there, but just nice to make a calculation for the hotels. Now, the land bank. This is what most bullish investors on Cresud expect to give the highest value. And unfortunately, I will have to disappoint them a little bit. So, Solares de Santa Maria is a 70-hectare property facing the Rio de la Plata in the south of Buenos Aires. The development project involves residential complexes, offices, stores, hotels, sports, sailing clubs, whatever. You can see here on the picture, they really plan it big. However, the plan was presented back in 2002 and still nothing happened since then. We are now 16 years ahead of that. There were some issues with legislators, still pending. 2017, there was a vote for the approval that was missed by one vote, so it didn't work. But now the plan is that there will be a new urban code in Buenos Aires, Nuevo Código Urbanístico, that will approve it or allow it with some changes. And the changes are very intriguing. I checked the code. This is the plan, the map in the new code, the new draft of the code, U73. And then I went reading and I saw, okay, area, edificable area is 30% for U73. And they can build buildings high 12 plus 15 meters, 15.5, that's 27 meters. Average 4 meters, as it has to be luxurious per story, I get to seven stories, parking and whatever comes in there. So that's one, so low raised buildings. And then on the high raised buildings, here they say that 1.5% of the edificable area will be without limit. So 1.5% of 21 hectares on the 70, that is the edificable area, gets me to 3.1 hectares or 3,100 square meters of high raised buildings. At 30 levels, it is 100,000 square meters to be built. Plus, if we add 150,000 from what can be built on the lower square buildings, I get to about 200,000 square meters to be built. Let's say 25% of that goes to halls and whatever, elevators, terraces and whatever. I get 150,000 square meters to be built. If I multiply that by, let's say, luxury 4,000, that gives me 600 million in value of what can be built there. 600 million in value. If I take a 15% profit margin for Cresud over 10 years, if that gets approved, I get to a value of 100 million for this land bank over the long term. So if I discount that, I get to 50 million. Now, there will be some changes. Perhaps they will enable it to make more. So I will put a value of 100 million max on that. Some people I have seen go to 700, 800 million on the value. But I don't think that Cresud will be allowed to build 18 high-rise buildings. They might be able to build 5 high-rise buildings. And here is a big difference in land values. So I get 100 million for the land bank. Other properties, Puerto Retiro, there is 8.3 hectares, so I'll include that in the land bank. Operations in Uruguay purchased that 2009 for 9 million, so they should be worth at least 20 million. Then let's go to international, the Israeli company and the other holdings. When you look at the operation center in Israel, that was divided on 2 companies and there is a lot of net debt. $963 million and $737 million. Now, the good things about all these companies is that they are all traded on the Israeli Stock Exchange or in New York. So I simply looked at the values of the market caps of all these companies, summed them up and got to the value of what would be Cresud's IRSA's holding there in Israel. So the EDBD part, Clel Insurance, they own 44.8% of that. The market cap is 850 million, their ownership should be 295 million, so around 300 million. Plus there are some other equity stakes in smaller companies from EDB and EDBG. I get that to 40 plus 30, 70 million. EDB, value of the assets, 365 million. Then we have Cellcom, 542 million market cap, value for the company 227 million. Property Building Corporation, value market cap 500 million, 320 for IRSA. Shufersal, 1.5 billion, 780 million for IRSA. Elron, 160 million market cap, 58 is the value. The sum of it all of the market caps is 1.3 billion. If I take off the net debt on the holding company, I get to a value of 50 million. Now, if those companies can be sold at a premium, then here the value really grows. And here is also one expectation of the unlocking on value. It's hardly unlikely that they will lose value there. They invested already 500 million in those debt securities, so that's how they got the value. But then my play is, why would I buy IRSA or Cresud? Why I don't simply buy stakes on the Israeli Stock Exchange in those companies and I get direct unlocking of the value? So if you want to invest in Cresud in that unlocking catalyst, then you might buy those stocks on the Israeli Stock Exchange. Their plan is to sell them at a premium, so you might see 50-100% gains there immediately. If you buy IRSA, then that money might go into different projects, paying off the debt, who knows what they will do. So if you want to play on that, perhaps it's better to buy the subsidiaries and play on individual plays. Perhaps you can get the money there directly and then invest for some other unlockings of value. Interesting play. Now, just an example of the valuation, why people see it as a great value. The HSBC building in New York, that's owned by Property and Building, so they own it, which is also something that is omitted from the value, is at 900 million. But the value is there and has been appraised so high. But there are leases, there are contracts, there are land issues, so many things that it's really difficult to get on the bottom of it. However, there is value. So another building that they own, 49% of it, lipstick building with the mortgage, with what they own, also huge value there. I estimated the value if they pay the debt, the rent, whatever they have, we get to 100 million for sure. 28% in Condor REIT, if they sell it at market values, there is another 35 million. Banco Hipotecario, their 30%, 300 million US dollars, market cap 30% is 100 million in value. So the total value of IRSA comes to 834 million, 1.1 billion in value of the assets, minus 342 of company holding debt is 834 million. The market cap is 1 billion, so it is a little bit overvalued for me. As said, I'm looking for really high returns. So that's my analysis on Cresud. A very complicated company. A lot of time, it will take a lot of time for all the value to get unlocked, and then you never know what will the CEO then do again with that money. So that's a discount. Argentina is at a high discount. That debt that he bought in Israel is also was also at a high discount. So a lot of debt there, a lot of issues there. So a lot of work there. And these companies, that's why I like the company, I'm keeping an eye on it. But if there is a recession in the next 1 to 3 years, this will be extremely cheap because of the leverage, because of the perception, because of emerging market exposure. So I think it will do great over the long term. If you want just to park your money in real estate for 10% over the long term, not care about ups and downs, I would recommend this company. But if you have to be ready to buy more when it's really cheap, I am a more enterprising, aggressive investor. I really wait for it to be cheap, which is not at the moment. Thank you for watching. I'm sorry if I disappointed you, but there will be more analysis, so we might find something better. I'll see you in the next video.